Marjorie Greene did not enter Congress with a lot of like knowledge or experience or curiosity about the world. And that's been demonstrated pretty consistently. Like last month when she said this, "I'm a regular person and I wanted to take my regular person, normal, everyday American values, which is we love our country." That got way too country. Anyway, we believe our hard-earned tax dollars should just go for America, not for what? China, Russia, the Middle East, Guam, whatever, wherever. Which is a weird thing to say about individual countries, entire regions of the world, and territories of the United States, which you should know because you've already been a congresswoman for like more than a month at that point. You've probably talked with their representative in the House of Representatives, but still thinks it's a foreign whatever, wherever. But thankfully, there have been some entreaties from Guam for her to potentially learn something with a bit of an olive branch. A delicious olive branch. So Crystal Paco San Agustin, communications director for the governor of Guam, said Congresswoman Greene is a new member and we'll be paying a visit to her and delivering delicious chamorro chip cookies as part of our ongoing outreach to new members to introduce them to our wonderful island of Guam. We would be more than happy to send Representative Greene's office a copy of Destiny's Landfall, a history of Guam. I would bet every cent I have and every cent I will ever have that she wouldn't read three pages of any book about the history of Guam. Like, I defy you. Here's a challenge for you for social media. Come up with something less likely to happen than her turning the last page on that book and saying, "I really learned a lot." Can't think of anything. You can't think of anything.
It's so stupid.
But anyway, Brett, yeah, Guam's territory and she doesn't know, doesn't care, won't learn, and in a month we'll have forgotten it.
Puerto Rico is one of my least favorite places in Mexico. Like, that's what it sounds like.
That's what it is.
Guam, it's so crazy. It's like at least she knows that Guam is a thing that exists. If I'm That's looking true. For the silver lining, she knows Guam's a thing, but she doesn't like Guam. And more, the problem is like she doesn't really. I'm sure there's a way to get through to her for so she could be proud that we have places like Guam, because I'm sure if you talk about like American imperialism and expansionism and having control over more places on the earth, she would be 100% all about it. Mm-hmm. But there is this fallacy that you really lock into, and you're right to do so, that being a normal everyday person is an excuse to let you be bad at something that is very essential to your job. And that doesn't apply anywhere else except two very key places. One, Congress, and two, really, it used to be like the one I could point to was like, who would you rather listen to? Someone who's like, I'll help, I'm not a doctor, or someone who says, I'll help, I'm a doctor. Like, I would rather have the doctor help, but That's not even real anymore, because a lot of these folks have become anti-vaxxers who look on the internet and are like, well, who should we listen to here? People who are experts or people who say very proudly that they have no idea what they're talking about. I'm gonna, you know, but the person who says they don't have any idea what they're talking about is speaking very confidently in a way that seems like they do think they know what they're talking about, but they're proud that they don't know what they're talking about. Maybe we should listen to them. No, you shouldn't. Let's listen to an expert.
Yeah. Or at the very least, someone who would like to know things and cares if what they say is true or not. We don't know if she has learned anything or cares. Her office did not respond to requests for comment. Does she care about any of this? Probably not. But maybe like a tiny bit, because we were gonna show you the video of her saying that, but it's been made unavailable. So someone in her office at least cares enough to take down the video of her saying something stupid. But there's a moving goalpost, because there's gonna be new stupid stuff next week. Anyway, really fast, just to make sure that people leave this video knowing even more than she knows. Guam, an island in the West Pacific Ocean, has been a US territory since 1898. So, you know, it's a little bit too recent for her to be aware of it. Following the Spanish-American War, its residents are US citizens who pay federal taxes, but not federal income tax. Many people in Guam serve in the US military, and it's considered to be of vital strategic importance. There are close to 6,200 active duty US troops in Guam, which is home to roughly 170,000 people. Guam residents cannot vote for president and do not have a vote in Congress. Like other US territories, they send a non-voting delegate to Congress, who I'm sure is gonna have some really awkward elevator rides with Marjorie Greene.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.